Welcome to the Spy Collection. My name is Anastasios, and in this episode, we'll have a look at a gadget from Israel. It's a device inside this bag. Cellebrite is an Israeli company focusing on digital intelligence and mobile data extraction. In 1999, Cellebrite was founded to solve a very practical problem. At that time, to extract information from a mobile device, you had to be an expert in multiple disciplines, including electronics, mobile security, computer science, and more. Cellebrite came up with the idea of simplifying this process. This way, in 1999, they introduced the Universal Memory Exchanger, or UME 12. It's the one you see in the photo, which unfortunately we do not have in the Spy Collection today. This device allowed you to connect a source device and a target device, and with high integrity and security, transfer data from the source to the target. 5 years later, in 2004, this was upgraded with a UME 24. And in 2007, we got this, the UME 36 Pro. Let's have a look. On the upper compartment of the case, we have the manual, a CD-ROM with Cellebrite software, and a quick reference guide. You can pause the video if you want to check it out. As you see here, Cellebrite took this very technically demanding subject of extracting data from a mobile device and turned it into a very user-friendly solution with just four main steps. Define the source phone or customer's old phone if it's a carrier service. Then define the target phone or customer's new phone, again if this is a carrier service. Select content to transfer, connect the phones and initiate the transfer of the contents. You also have a reference of the screens of the device that you will see as you are conducting this. Now let's put that to the side and see that the case only has two more things. It has this large case and the actual device. So let's have a look at the case first. This device was introduced in 2007. And as you saw from the quick reference guide, its target audience wasn't only digital forensics experts, but also carriers that use those to transfer data from one device to another for the customers. Actually, there are even some versions branded after specific providers, like this one from O2 in Germany. If you check the brochure of the device or the quick guide, you'll see that in 2007, the UME 36 Pro was supporting over 95% of all handsets at the market at that time. That was over 3,000 different mobile models. To achieve that, this was a key component of the kit. This is a cable organizer secured with Velcro, containing all the potential cables you will find in those mobile devices that will allow you to connect them to the UME 36 Pro. Now imagine the amount of research that went into creating all of this kit. Cellebrite engineers would have to reverse engineer all of these different mobile phones to understand how the pins work, how are the different connectors constructed, and how you can take this and only use it for extracting data. This is why this collection of adapters is a pretty unique and impressive engineering milestone by itself. Of course, we're not going to go through each and every single cable, but you can imagine the complexity of creating something like that for over 3,000 devices in 2007. But of course, this is not what made this device so successful in this industry. It was the device itself. And here is the Universal Memory Exchanger for Mobile Phones 36 Pro from Cellebrite from 2007. It was a device based on the Windows operating system that it was very user-friendly with only a handful of keys, as you see here. On the left side we have the source, where it could be an SD card, it could be one of the connectors that we saw from the cable, a USB, an infrared connector, and we could even export the data to a SIM card or a smart card by inserting it over here. And on the right side we have the target, where to export the data. And of course we have the same connectors, infrared, USB, and the cable adapter from the kit, as well as the power socket. Finally, on its top side, we have two external USB ports for the Bluetooth dongle or other external devices, an Ethernet network port to get automatic updates, a serial port for maintenance, and another USB connector for connecting the device with the software that comes in its CD-ROM. Technically speaking, it's a tailor-made computer running an Intel X-Tail microarchitecture processor at 520 MHz and with an embedded 128 MB RAM. Probably people would be interested to know how it looks like when it's powered on. To do that, we're going to plug in the power adapter. And it takes a while to boot, and afterwards it gives us the license and the main menu. This one is in German. You navigate everything with the buttons that you see here. So let's have a look at the statistics. Now let's power it off. And do a breakdown of its internals. If we open up the case, we can see the SIM card reader, the programming slash debugging interface, as well as the infrared sensors here and here. On the other side, we have the keypad and the screen, as well as a better view of all of the components. Let's disconnect the keypad and the screen to have a closer look. Okay, and now let's go back. Although the initial target audience was carriers to help their customers change from one device to another, the ease of use and practicality of this device quickly drew the attention of investigators. For instance, here is what we're reading in the 2007 book E-Forensics and Investigations for Everyone. It is also noteworthy that some cell phone devices, such as the Cellebrite UME 36 Pro PPU, can be used by cell phone forensics examiners who wish to quickly get SMS messages, images, and cell phone numbers from one cell phone to either another type of phone or a computer storage device. This device has such an intuitive interface and is so easy to operate that most people feel no training is necessary. The device is very widely used by people who sell cell phones and transfer information from the Trio to Blackberries and a multitude of other phones. Investigators in a variety of communities are also said to use such devices. The device is pictured in Figure 13.1. And in case you wonder what did it mean by a variety of communities, This device was very popular in the intelligence community as well as law enforcement, since it reduced the training needs for people to get familiar with collecting evidence from mobile devices. For example, we have this brochure from October 2007 from the SEARCH, the National Consortium for Justice Information and Statistics of the United States. It is titled Law Enforcement Investigative Use of Cellebrite's UME 36 Pro. And among others, it says, these are suggested guidelines for use of Cellebrite's UME 36 Pro by law enforcement investigators who conduct cellular telephone investigations. Officially, the life of the UME 36 Pro ended in 2013, in January of 2013. Apparently, it was replaced by a newer device with more capabilities that we will look at in a future video. Actually, it was this transition from the UME 36 Pro to the newer device where Cellebrite became a market leader in the intelligence world. But of course, this had already started with this device. Even if we look at far more recent publications, like this book from 2020, The Digital Forensics and Forensic Investigations, Breakthroughs in Research and Practice, we will find the following reference about the UME 36 Pro. The UME 36 Pro enables logical, password, SIM, file system and physical extractions of data from mobile devices. It is a hardware solution for data extraction. The extracted data can be viewed and analyzed with a UFED physical analyzer software. UME 36 Pro claims to extract the following data from a smartphone: call logs, contacts, email, pattern logs, bookmarks, cookies, text strings from SMS, MMS, chat messages, location data including cell tower locations and usage, web browser history including records of visited websites, digital photography, digital videos and audio files, text files, deleted data, Wi-Fi including connection times, BSSID, SSID and security modes, GPS information added to the media, geotags. From 2007 and until 2013, that was the end of life for this unique device, its cost was roughly $1,300. This device was the beginning of an entire different domain in intelligence collection known as CELEX, cellular exploitation. As its name implies, CELEX is how to extract information that can be turned into intelligence from cellular devices. And devices like that made it exceptionally easy for law enforcement as well as intelligence agencies at a global scale. Within minutes, either a law enforcement agent can copy data used in a criminal investigation, or an intelligence officer can break into a place, quickly plug the devices to something like this one, extract all of the data and leave the site unnoticed. In later years, there were even some black pages in the history of Cellebrite due to some of those activities, but we will look at that in a future video. For now, remember that nothing is as it seems.